Hey y'all, welcome to What Chelsea Eats. Thank you so much for joining me today. I am going to share with you my thoughts on how long it takes to heal from a myomectomy. But first, I'm so glad you landed on my channel. My name is Chelsea Knutson and I'm a certified holistic life and health coach, and I coach women on how to heal naturally from female related conditions. So don't forget to subscribe to this channel and hit the notification bell so you never miss an episode. So what is a myomectomy? A myomectomy is a surgical procedure that is used to remove fibroids from a woman's uterus. Most of the time, this procedure is used to preserve a woman's fertility. First of all, I want to say I personally have never gotten a myomectomy, but I have many clients that I work with on a regular basis that have had myomectomies. You may be saying to yourself, well, if they got a myomectomy, why are they working with a coach that helps women to heal naturally from fibroids? Well, I'm glad you asked. The reason that I work with women who have had myomectomies is because a myomectomy is not a guarantee that the fibroids won't grow back. In a lot of cases, when women get fibroids, within 1 to 6 years, the fibroids are back and they are back with a vengeance. I've even had some women say that once they've gotten the surgery, a few months later, they started getting the same symptoms and can feel the fibroids growing rapidly. So these women, in some cases, will come and work with someone to help them shrink them naturally because they don't want to undergo the surgery anymore. So depending on where the fibroids are located and the size, you may qualify for one of four types of myomectomy surgeries. The one that is the most invasive is the abdominal myomectomy. It is where they open your womb up. Open up your stomach and they cut the fibroid actually off of the uterus or out of the uterus. The other surgeries are the hysteroscopic, I think that's how you pronounce it, the robotic and the laparoscopic type myomectomies. And all of these types of myomectomies come with their own set of recovery. And recovery ranges from the doctor's perspective, from medical perspective, they say anywhere from you can return to work on the first day all the way up to 8 weeks of after the surgery you can return, depending on the type of surgery you're getting and how your body is actually responding to the surgical procedure. Although each type of myomectomy surgery has its own level of invasiveness, they all involve some type of surgical cutting. And cutting on the body is traumatic, no matter how you cut it, because it's foreign. Something foreign is happening to the body, so the body is going to respond to that. And all women are going to respond differently. No one can say exactly how your body is going to respond. There will be some similarities in some cases, in most cases really, but everybody is different. Some women even go through the surgery and find out afterwards that the doctor wasn't even able to get all of the fibroid tissue, because if the doctor would have continued to cut, the integrity of the womb would have been compromised because it would have been too much cutting. And a lot of the women that are opting to get a myomectomy are trying to preserve their fertility, so therefore the doctors are hesitant to continue to cut. So sometimes you come out of the surgery still having fibroid tissue on the womb. Now, every myomectomy surgery is not horrible. Some women get a myomectomy and they are great. They bounce back. There's no problems. They are on the top of the world because all of their quote unquote problems have gone away, and they feel great. They are no longer bloated. They're not bleeding the way they used to bleed, and everything is great. But then there are some, and then the recovery is very quick. They don't have any problems. They're back on their feet, back to work, no issues. But then there are some women who have the myomectomy surgery and it's taken them a little while to get back into the place where they feel normal again. Some women get a myomectomy and nothing's changed as far as their bleeding or bloating or anything. So it just really depends on what's going on in your body. It probably depends on the surgeon, and it probably depends on how you are taking care of yourself. So let's go to what some of my clients have reported. The majority of the clients that I work with, most of them have gotten the myomectomy surgery, and within like about 1 year, 2 years, 3 years, they're back in the same position where the fibroids have grown back, and they felt better after their surgery, but they didn't do anything to change their lifestyle that caused the fibroids to grow in the first place. So they are pretty much in the same boat that they were when they first started out with fibroids. But then I have women who have expressed, because I think these women are particularly in tune with their bodies. They've reported that they had the fibroid surgery. The fibroids grew back because of lifestyle and stress and, you know, not taking care of themselves. But they also reported that their wound area just never felt the same anymore. Like it was disjointed, and it took a long time where they actually felt like their body actually healed properly. So even though they didn't have any open wounds, they didn't have any, you know, terrible scars or any major lack of recovery going on in their bodies, like, yes, they were healed, but they just felt off. But then there were the women who just felt disjointed from the surgery, and it felt like it took them a few years to actually feel like themselves again. So my observation from working with all of these women is that it ranges from, you know, a few days people are feeling better to a few years until people actually really feel like themselves again. And you don't know where you're going to be in that range. You just don't when you get the surgery. So if you decide to get the surgery, make sure you have that in your mind, that you're going to do everything that you can to allow your body the rest that it needs from going and jumping right back into things. Even if you have one of these non-invasive surgery options, give your body time to heal, because you don't know what your body needs. So listen to your body, give yourself rest, don't be under a whole lot of stress, feed your body well, keep your body hydrated so that your body can do what it was designed to do, which is to heal itself. And the reason that you need to take the time to do this is because all surgery is traumatic. It doesn't matter whether you're getting a myomectomy, a hysterectomy, a tooth pulled, a wisdom tooth pulled. It's still traumatic on the body because there's cutting happening. There's things happening that is not an everyday occurrence. It's not natural for your body to get cut on. So that's going to register in your body as a trauma. So give your body what it needs so that it can heal. So even if your doctor says that you could go back to work after a 1 day surgery, if I'm in your shoes, I'm going to take a little bit more time to try to at least make sure that it's 1 day. Just give my body a few days, a week, 2 weeks if you can do it, just to give yourself the time it needs to get back into the swing of things. I'm not saying go against your doctor, but there's nothing wrong with resting a little bit more just to give your body what it needs. So you made a decision to get a myomectomy. How in the world do you keep these things from coming back? The first place to start is with diet. I tell everybody this, diet, diet, diet. You have to stop putting the food in your body that caused the conditions in your body for fibroids to grow. And usually that's toxicity, estrogen dominance. And there are even some foods that cause stress because they're hard on the digestion. They're just hard on the body because they're not real foods. They are junk foods, if you will. So if you want to see which foods I recommend to avoid, go up in the cards above or down in the description box and download the free ebook called Foods to Avoid to Help You Shrink Fibroids Naturally. And then you can get the list of the foods to avoid to help you to keep these fibroids from growing back. Because if you don't change, it is a high probability that they will grow back. Because surgery doesn't solve the problem, it just cuts the problem out. You can also go back on my YouTube channel and watch the videos talking about fibroids. Most of the videos on this channel are about fibroids and female reproductive issues in general. And you can get more information as to why food contributes to fibroids and what other factors contribute to fibroids growing. And once you look at that list, you might look at it and say, oh my goodness, she took away all of my food options. Well, a good portion of them are taken away, but there are so many more foods that you actually can eat. And so there are recipes on my channel. I have a playlist link down in the description box below with most of my recipes in it. You can also visit me on Instagram at whatchelseaeats to see the types of foods that I eat on a regular basis. And there is also a 7-day meal plan that you can purchase. The link is down in the description box and I'll put it up in the cards as well. If you are trying to figure out what it is that you need to eat or want to, that you can eat on a regular basis to help keep your body healthy, to help keep these fibroids from growing back in the future. Also, if you're someone who's had the fibroids grow back and you want to learn how to shrink the fibroids naturally, my next 90-day Walk to Freedom from Fibroids group coaching program starts on April 6th. So you're welcome to join. There's a link in the description box for that as well. So if this video has been helpful, please let me know in the description, in the comment section. I would love to hear what you think. Please feel free to comment and let me know what types of videos you would like to see coming up. Also, if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, share it with a friend, and don't forget to subscribe. Until next time, y'all, take care.